Hello everybody, for all of you who are new on the channel, I'm Dhanya Varma, I'm a talk show host and this channel is all about positivity, it's about growth, it's about fighting and finding ways to deal with life's challenges, exploring new ideas and places and so much more. Now, if you have watched the content on this channel, do remember to subscribe if you like the content and share it with your friends and family. Now, let's get going. So I've been talking about emotional intelligence for a long time now. In many of my videos, I've been telling you that I will make a video on emotional intelligence, and finally the day has come. Whether you like it or not, emotions do play a very important role in our lives. Now the key here is to be aware and to be able to manage those emotions. Now how can you do that? That's what we're going to talk about in this video. What it's going to help you with is to better manage your personal and your professional life. You know, we all like to believe that we are very rational, logical human beings. But if you look at the 10 to 20 major decisions that you have taken in your life, you will understand that they were not driven completely by logic and reason, but primarily there was an underlying emotion or a feeling that was driving you towards that decision you took. I can talk about myself. I believe that I'm a very logical person. My husband too thinks on the same lines. But when it came to deciding on which car to purchase, it was emotions that led us to purchase that car. I'll tell you what happened. We went to a showroom. We had decided on which car, which model, what to purchase. We went to the showroom and we met the salesperson there. Now that person was very annoying and very irritable and extremely pushy, so much so that we felt cornered completely into buying that car. We had made our minds up and we had decided on that car, but just the way he was behaving with us and the fact that we were so irritable and annoyed led us to purchase another car. I'm glad we purchased the other car, it's a good one, but we would have purchased the previous one if it was not for that salesperson who made us irritable and angry. Frankly, I had not heard about emotional intelligence until a few years ago. I had heard, of course, about IQ. Everybody knows about IQ, intelligence quotient. But EQ is seldom talked about. Emotional intelligence has seen a relevance in today's context where people are dealing with mental health issues in a big way. In your company, if there is a boss who is always yelling and screaming, and especially when there is stress, he is taking out on other people, how would you feel about working under such a person? You would feel dreadful, right? Going to work would feel so miserable. On the contrary, if you had a boss who is cool, who's calm and collected and always encouraging, positive, and also during times of stress is able to take that stress in without being volatile and reactive about it, that would be a dream boss to work for. In fact, you would give out your best output, right? So how do we work on ourselves? How do we learn to manage our own emotions? It's a slow process. Remember, Rome wasn't built in a day. So let's get going on that. So basically, emotional intelligence consists of two parts. One is personal competence and the other is social competence. Now, when you talk about personal competence, it's basically the ability to identify your own emotions. That is called self-awareness, being aware of your own emotions. When you feel emotional or when you are behaving in a certain way, asking yourself why. Why am I behaving in a certain way? What is the reason, that the underlying cause that is making me behave in a certain way? What am I thinking and what am I feeling? Now that is a way to get self-aware. And every time you feel low, you're upset, you're guilty, you're angry, identifying that particular emotion and that correct emotion is the first step. The second step is to be able to manage one's own emotions. Now that's the difficult part. Now I'm an emotional person. I'm able to identify what emotions I'm going through, or maybe I am able to identify why I'm behaving in a certain way, but I find it very difficult to manage my own emotions. Sometimes when the tears flow, they just keep flowing and they just don't stop. So that's the difficult part in my opinion. That's managing your emotions and channelizing your emotional energy constructively. So emotional intelligence is essentially of four parts. The first two parts we have covered, which is self-awareness. The second is managing your own emotions. The third one is social awareness, where you are able to identify and recognize somebody else's emotions, which I think I'm not bad at. But the fourth part, which is relationship management, ayo, that's a tough one. That's where you're able to kind of coordinate, you're able to manage, you're able to handle other people's emotions in a social setup or maybe even your workplace, wherever it is. If you're able to manage other people's emotions and use it constructively, then that is relationship management. If you're able to do that, wow, you're already up there. Now, have you heard about the ABCs of emotions? Well, A stands for the activating event or situation. B stands for the belief and C for the consequences. You're in your office, you're watching someone, you have a presentation be done in the evening, you've asked your colleague to prepare it, and this person, instead of preparing it, he's sitting and chatting with somebody else. What would your belief tell you? That is the activating situation, right? Now, what would your belief tell you? Your belief will tell you that, look at this fellow, what a incompetent person he is. He's not using his time effectively, he's talking to his friend. What a waste of time. And you get angry. Now, when you get angry, that is your consequence. That's how you're responding to that situation. And you probably yell at him, or probably you sulk, or you kind of, call him to your office and ask him what the reason is. Now, these are the different responses you can have as per the belief that you, the belief that you carry. So now you remove that belief and place another belief in it. Say, for instance, you could probably think that, it is a very important call and probably he has to attend that call. Maybe that's why he's talking to his friend. Maybe it's something very, very important. And you let go at that. So therefore, the belief has changed and hence the consequence has also changed. So now you don't have anger or rage or any of those ill feelings towards him. And therefore, you don't have a confrontation. The situation completely changes, right? So this is the ABC of emotional responses. Now you can understand how your belief system or the way you view things actually is the link between A and C, which is the activating event and the consequences. So what we need to focus on is also the belief system that operates in your head when you look at a situation. Another point which I have to very much emphasize on is this cycle of thought, feeling and behavior. When we think, you feel in a certain way, your body responds in a certain way, there is an emotional response, and then you behave in a certain way. And then it gets into a cycle. Say, for instance, you wake up in the morning, you look in the mirror, and you say, I'm no good. This day is going to be really bad. Then 100% certainty, your day is going to turn out bad because you thought in a certain way, your body is going to respond or feel in a certain way. And then even if you have great opportunities or a positive situation coming your way, you would end up rejecting it because you have gotten into that cycle. It's very important to identify what really are you thinking and how are you feeling, and you need to break that cycle if it is getting into a negative dark cycle. Keeping a watch on our behavior is also equally important. Using the right words to express. The right words to express how you're feeling or what you're thinking at that moment is also very crucial to interpersonal relationships. So that's another point you need to focus on, which is how do you express your thoughts and your feelings? Say, for instance, you had a fight with your spouse. Can you take a moment, collect yourself, look back and find out, was there anything that you could have replaced the choice of words with? When you had an argument, you would have certainly used certain harsh words. Could you have replaced these harsh words with something better that would have better communicated or more effectively communicated how you felt at that moment? So using your words very carefully, like they say, is very important too. Another quality that you would find in an emotionally intelligent person is certainly empathy. Empathy is where you can actually feel what the other person's feeling. You might end up disagreeing with them or you might not agree with their thought process, but you still understand where they come from. This can be done by observing them or trying to know their stories about themselves or where they're coming from, or to put yourself in others' shoes. Now, this has helped me in my workplace. Many a time when I put myself in their situation, I seem to understand them a lot better. Take stock of what your stresses are, be proactive about it, and try to have less of it in your life. For instance, I know for a fact that if I'm sleep deprived, I'm very irritable. It's very difficult for me to manage another day if I have not slept well the previous night. And similarly, hunger. If I'm hungry, like in that ad that you see on television, I become a diva or become a monster. I don't know what, but either ways, it doesn't work for me or for the people around me. I need to constantly keep something to eat. People who work with me at shoots, they know that I do normally carry biscuits or bananas or sandwiches so that I don't have to get hungry and, you know, kind of take it all out on people around me. So stress for me is hunger and sleep deprivation at a physical level. And of course, there are other things that stress me out, especially certain kinds of people. But identifying your stresses can certainly help you manage yourself and people around you better. Guys, I could really make a very, very long video on emotional intelligence, but I don't want to do that. I don't want to bore you to death. I would rather have you pick up that book, Emotional Intelligence by Daniel Goldman, and read it page to page. Every line carries a lot of valuable information, things that you could apply in your day-to-day life. So please read that book. And if there are any people around that I could learn a lesson or two from in your lives, please leave the story or the situation below, or tell us more about those people and those traits that you find admirable in the emotionally intelligent person that he or she is. I would love to know your thoughts. Let's have a conversation here in the comment section. So do share your thoughts and your emotions or feelings about this particular video in the comment section below. Looking forward to hearing from you, and do leave that like if you like the video and share it with your friends and family. Take care. Watch the other videos on my channel as well, and subscribe if you like them.